There are some amazing tactics in Marvel's Avengers to get to the max power level extremely fast, like great farm spots for legendary gear or upgrade modules to get like more than 100 of them in less than an hour, and there are some other smart tactics that you totally want to know about. So I want to go over all of them in this video. A like would really help the channel out. And let's go. You can still enter the second 2000 credit pack giveaway, so you don't have to spend money yourself, but can still get things from the marketplace. There's a link in the pinned comment, click that, and be sure you are a subscriber of the channel as well before you enter, and I will reach out to the winner via the email. Okay, let's start with an amazing upgrade module farm, because that is of course the thing. Gear will drop till power level 130, so to get it to 140, you need resources, including a lot of upgrade modules. Well, we got Osterberg on YouTube, who I will link to in the video description, with a very smart tactic, and this should work on every optional high value target in the game, but we tried here on the target in the Day of the Remains Inhuman faction mission, that as I noted before, unlocks when you reach step 3 of the Reigning Supreme mission, and then by following the Inhuman mission chain that then shows up in your objectives menu, you actually get to this mission at some point. But also, if a friend of yours already has the Day of the Remains mission, you can just join them and then complete the mission, and then it should show up on your war table as well, so then you skip the whole Reigning Supreme stuff. I will talk about those changed rewards and another secret in the mission in a second, by the way. But let's focus first on the upgrade module tactic. So you first want to complete the main objective in the mission, where you just have to go to a location and then head to the question mark that turns into the high value target. Now only focus on this target with the icon, and after you take it out, grab the loot and the upgrade modules, and now you want to run away, like go back to the start of the mission. Iron Man and Thor are really the best for this farm, because they can just fly away, of course. With the other characters, you have to just run a little bit further, and it takes a little bit longer, but it should still work. Because at one point, you want to turn around and actually go back to the location with the high value target. Because if you were far enough, you will see the portals again, meaning that the enemies are respawning, including this elite high value target. He will not have an icon this time, but you can easily notice him thanks to the shield. So just keep an eye out, kill this enemy again, like focus everything you have on this enemy alone. Don't kill the others. Then grab the loot, and then you wanna like run away again or fly away again. And then when you are like far enough, turn around, go over to the high value target location again. He should respawn, and then you can just do this tactic over and over again and get like more than 100 upgrade modules in an hour pretty easily. Good to note is that you want to do this mission on the highest difficulty, because this will give you 3 upgrade modules each time you kill the high value target instead of 2 that you get on challenge rank 2. And a high power level is also required, because when you are low, you will only get 1 upgrade module no matter the difficulty. But yeah, on a low power level, farming for upgrade modules is not really needed, so totally do this on a high power level on challenge 4 for a ton of legendaries on 130 and 3 upgrade modules each time you kill the target. If you're having trouble, you can put the difficulty down to fast to kill the enemy, but then you get 2 upgrade modules and also lower gear rarity drops. And by the way, an easy way to get to that 130 power level first, if you're still a lower level, is just farming that Day of the Remains mission and doing it offline. Because what is interesting, thanks to Remorius for reaching out to me about this on Twitter at Geraptor, you can also reach out with interesting finds via the input at geraptor.com email address. If you namely complete the Day of the Remains mission offline, you still get that amazing legendary with a pretty high power level from completing the mission, just like a blue pattern. But if you play online, they changed the end of the mission rewards to an epic item with max power of 130 and 1 or maybe 2 upgrade modules. So boot the game offline and go to the campaign, and then select the mission from the war table there, and you will get the rewards from before the update, making power leveling way easier. This will likely change with the next update that we have to download, but for now and in the future, it's interesting to remember that this works. And we actually found a new shield cache in this Day of the Remains mission, so you can get even more out of each run. It's to the left from where you start. You don't have to complete the main objective first, but can immediately go here. And then a tracker will appear that you just want to follow to open this bunker and get all the chests. And did you, by the way, know that you can break walls in the different bunkers? That will include some extra resources. It's not a lot, but still nice to get while doing this run anyways. But yeah, this means that there are two shield caches in this mission that you can get each time that also give pretty nice rewards and vault coordinates. So it's pretty insane. I did the full run of this farm in a recent video that I will link to in the video description for if you want to see it. It's really an amazing way to level up fast in terms of XP and also get to that 130 power level. And since we now got a ton of upgrade modules and know how to easily get them thanks to that farm, it will be worth it to spend it on gear or just get gear in general at the vendors as well. The loot you will find here will namely have a pretty high power level, sometimes higher than what you currently have equipped. So buying the items and equipping it can give you an easy and major boost. But also when you are at 130 and beyond, checking the stores to find the best perks that you want for a specific build will be very nice. You of course need to upgrade your faction rank to buy more items from these faction specific vendors. And ranking up will, by the way, also give you upgrade modules, and completing the faction missions each time you play, and that's of course something you likely do already, will also give you Polycaron, and that is needed for the major artifact. And of course, upgrading that to the plus 10 power will in the end get you to 150 combined with all the gear pieces on 140. And the high rank priority mission will help you get to that, because this will have a one-time weekly reward of 50 upgrade modules, Polycaron, and a powerful legendary. So totally do it each week before the new one appears. And this week, at the time of this recording, it's the Rocket's Red Glare, so the Captain America iconic mission, and you will like see the priority mission as the chest icon, and the regular iconic mission will still be there. And I've used the regular mission many times now for other resources that are also needed to upgrade your gear or buy stuff from the vendor. And if you just focused on these resources, then totally pick Iron Man, because he can easily reach everything and also open all the chests in the mission. When you start the level, there are many fragments already laying around that you can just fly to get. They will also be behind you. And then on the different platforms, there are even more resources. So totally take the time to grab all of them. There are two chests in the building on your right hand side from where you start the mission. You can open the upper one with the Hulkbuster, and the other one has like an easy puzzle that is different each time. And this will like include the golden chest, which gives you some pretty nice rewards. And yeah, you can do it alone, but with a team with different characters, it's also really easily doable. Going back to Iron Man though, because we also want to check the chest on the floating platform in front of the exosuit. The exosuit is needed for the main objective, so totally take that out afterwards. And after you've done that, you can open the door to the chest like before you head into this hallway. But only Black Widow and Iron Man can open this door. So that's again why Iron Man is really nice. In the next open area, there will also be like a ton of resources that you can grab. After that, you just want to continue with the mission. There's another chest after taking the elevator. Like overall, there are a ton of resources in a relatively small space. And if your character is not level 50 yet, you also get like 2 levels per run. I really love this one. These tactics should really help you get to 150 relatively fast. Subscribe for way more Marvel's Avengers content if you haven't already. A like on the video would really help the channel out. If you got input, input@geraptor.com, or let me know in the comments. And totally check out my previous video on how to level up fast to 50 and get all the skill points. For now though, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.